Welcome back to the Traders Network. I'm Michael Yorba, your host. Thanks for joining us. We're also streaming to you live on YorbaMedia.com. All right, Nick Santiago, President and CEO in TheMoneyStocks.com. Nick, welcome back. How are you?
Great to be back, Michael. Thank you for having me.
All right, my pleasure. We got a lot of rock and roll going on here today. What do you got to say?
Well, we have a little Fed announcement happening today. I think these markets are really starting to look very vulnerable to the downside, in my opinion. I think traders need to, any long plays out there need to start to tighten their belt. But we're starting to see some cracks in the armor here, first beginning with Federal Express. And I think that traders should take note of that. If all this money is being printed and the transports are soaring, Federal Express should not be having an earnings deceleration cycle upon them. So I think that's a big problem.
Let everybody know FDX, the symbol.
Yep, the ticker symbol is FDX, and Federal Express is by far the largest transportation company in the world. They ship worldwide. Everybody has probably used them. And today they really come out and warn, and I think that is really problematic going forward.
They got bludgeoned today.
Excuse me?
They got bludgeoned today.
Bludgeoned is an understatement, yeah. You know, they're still falling. I mean, the stock right now is trading at $99. It closed yesterday around 106 and change. So this is not a good sign overall for the market, especially when all this money is being created by central banks around the world. And I think it is a warning sign of epic proportion.
Okay, that's definitely something we should take note of. Give me some support levels you think we may hit if we do hit them.
On FedEx?
Yeah.
Well, I think right now FedEx is probably headed down to $93.
Okay.
That's where traders should look for a potential bounce in the stock. It may even go a little bit lower, down to around 91.50, 91.80. There's a big gap fill there going all the way back to, it actually goes back to New Year's Eve,
yep.
So 2012. So I think that's a gap that's on the radar to get filled now.
Okay, real close to the 200 period moving average. Got it.
Yep, 200 is right around 92, 93 bucks.
Okay, do you think that's going to find some support there, or is this the crack in the dike of much bigger problems?
Well, I think it will find some support there because anytime there's any problems here, the central banks come and run into the rescue. You know, they're going to promise more, do more. What can they do more? They could just simply, you know, print more money and throw more money at the system. That's the only, resolution. And granted, for a trader, it's great. I mean, I honestly want to send Ben Bernanke Christmas cards and even gifts, you know, for the past 4 years. It's been great. It's been a trader's market. But we're at a stage now where, I think traders need to be concerned that the easy money cycle could be ending.
Okay, well, when you say that, what are the other indicators that are telling you besides FedEx that's giving you the reason to have that opinion?
Well, another reason is J.P. Morgan. This is the real Bank of America, and if you notice, I talked about it on your show. I think it was last week. I said we're coming up into a big, big resistance level. I mean, I can't rule out that it wouldn't trade up to $52, but this stock is now starting to lag stocks like Bank of America, and J.P. Morgan is by far the most important financial. So if that stock goes, then the market's really in for trouble. I still have 2013 penciled in as a trader's year, not the ultimate bear market, but at this stage of the game, this market has been roaring and soaring on, you know, QE Infinity and all of this other stuff. And then when you get decelerating earnings from a company like Federal Express, it's really a big eye opener for any trader out there.
Okay. Do you see this trend in, because it, you know, the Dow was moving up, but this is starting to fall. The bricks underneath the bridge are starting to fall away, is what you're saying.
It's reminding me a lot of 2007, 2008. I mean, in 2007, we had three crashes before the final top was made in October 2007. So, nothing breaks down right away. As you said, you know, it just deteriorates. And we're starting to see, look at the trading volumes in the market. These are not even healthy trading volumes right now. So on this move to the upside. And I think cyclically we're in a time period now where traders really need to understand how cycles work, because we're in a pivotal, pivotal month as far as cycles go. And this is a time to be really concerned.
Okay, well, that's what I was going to come to, because I have big cycle dates that are showing up for super high volatility. One of which is the 23rd, which is actually on the weekend. So you'd have to move it out to like the 25th, a Monday. Mm-hmm. Coming up pretty close. And I just wanted to see how my stuff's working with your stuff, because you're undoubtedly has been exceptionally good at forecasting what's going to happen next. So how does your cycle setup look?
Well, I'm looking at basically within a zone, because we don't have really this market move that really began in November. Some can make a case for June 2012. The market's really been on a parabolic rise. It's hard to pinpoint the exact date. So, but we're in the window now of extreme volatility and potential sharp corrections occurring at any moment.
Okay, let's move some other stocks through here, or some ETFs that you want to bring onto the table.
Yeah, a few other things that I wanted to talk about today was gold, the GLD. And right now I think the GLD has some upside potential to maybe around the 159 level, but I don't see it really getting through there. And I know I've been getting flooded with emails saying, hey, where's this gold market going? Can I still own gold? And I think you can, up into around the 159, maybe 160 level. On the GLD, and then I think it will stall out. From there, I'm not sure exactly what's going to happen. We'll have to look at the chart pattern and see what it's telling us as it develops.
Okay. All right. I noticed that you've also got GDX on here, too. You want to talk
about? Yeah, GDX I want to talk about a little bit as well, because that's the gold mining stocks. They're not reacting as strong as gold, the metal itself, at the moment. So I think that is worth noting. I do think that the GDX did put in a significant low, at least a short-term low, around March 6th. But I think traders still need to be careful with this one. But we'll give it the upside to maybe around 40 and a half, somewhere around there. I really have a hard time seeing it get much higher, though.
Okay. Was it VAL that you wanted to talk about next, or UAL?
The next one I had was UAL.
UAL.
Which is, yeah. That's United Airlines,
right?
And I think this stock is very close to topping out today.
This is a big Texas company. You know this, right?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Yes, I do.
Topping out today, huh?
Houston-based, I know. Flown it many times. But, yeah, I do think this stock may have put in a short-term top today, or if not, maybe just a pierce of that 33 level. It should be the end of this run.
Okay, and with that being said, do you have any idea where it may fall to?
I certainly do. I'm thinking a move back down to around $29 and then potentially around $26.
From 32 to 29, maybe 26.
First downside target would be around $29. After that, I'm thinking 26, maybe 26.50, somewhere in there.
Okay, all right. And then U.S. Airways, I can't leave without saying this. This is a classic. I'm looking at it. It's a classic. Go ahead. Take it from there.
Well, U.S. Airways is in the same boat. This one could easily come back to $15.50, and then ultimately around probably $14. There's a big, big gap window that needs to be filled from March 5th. So this is another one. In fact, I think the entire airline sector is ready for the pullback beginning today.
All right. You got two gaps, and then would you call this a spinning top as far as Japanese candlesticks go?
Yeah, well, you're getting the inverted hammer up here. Depends on how it closes. I'm not sure how it's going to close in the next 15 minutes, obviously. But this is a third breakaway gap in a row, and that's usually the end of it.
Okay, so what are you doing with this? Are you writing cover calls with these stocks, or are you shorting them outright, or just saying get out?
That's a good way to play it, but I'm looking to see if I get a gap up tomorrow to sell into this, to be honest.
Okay.
I think, when they get these euphoric moves like this, they have a tendency to gap up in the morning, and we call it a gapping crap. So maybe this one can gap up, and then I think it could fade from there, and that'll be put in a nice little topping tail or something like that. Another way to play it, if you're bullish to group, is to write covered calls, take in some premium, and then, you can look to hold it, because I do think they're bounce candidates once they get down to those final levels. But at this stage of the game, I would not. If you own it, I would be trailing that stop loss. And if you want to short it, this is your opportunity.
All right. Appreciate that. All right. Especially the new coin phrase. I appreciate that, too. All right, Nick, we got to go. But before we do, again, tell our audience how they can participate with you in this trading room.
Sure. Come on over to InTheMoneyStocks.com. We offer a 7-day free trial to our research center and also to our intraday stock chat room, where you'll get all of our trade setups each and every day. You'll also get to see our screen live. The research center will give you all of our cycle work as well as all of our nightly setups that we have. And, we've had a great 2013 so far.
Yeah, I'm sure you got a few good trades you had to date in that room, right?
Every day, Michael, every day.
Tomorrow should be very exciting for these airline stocks. I can't wait.
Yeah, tomorrow, airline stocks, and also watch for a pullback in the home builders as well.
Oh.
Yeah, it looks like Lennar may have topped out today as well.
Symbol for everybody?
Ticker symbol is LEN, Larry Edward Nancy.
Got it. All right, get in the room tomorrow with Nick, and you're going to see him pull some. Whoa, look at that thing. Yeah, okay. Enough said. All right, I got to go. We'll talk to you next week, Nick.
All right, Michael. Have a great day.
You too. Nick Santiago, you're welcome, Nick. Nick Santiago, president and CEO, InTheMoneyStocks.com. Where do you see these trades come off tomorrow? It's going to be amazing. All right, coming up next.